On September 17, 2006, it was a peaceful day in south central Alaska. The skies were unusually clear for the time of year, so it thus came as a surprise when several people in Kodiak, Homer, and Anchorage reported a great plume of ash rising into the atmosphere. These people subsequently phoned the Alaskan Volcano Observatory, reporting that the plume was originating just southwest of the Douglas Volcano, near where a secondary small peak was located. This secondary peak was referred to as Fourpeaked and was at the time thought to either be extinct or dormant. What had just begun was the initial phase of an unexpected phreatic eruption from a volcano which had not erupted in at least 10,000 years, potentially longer. This unexpected eruption served as a friendly reminder that volcanoes can go on the order of tens of thousands of years between individual eruptions, much like seen at McDonald Island in Australia, which hadn't erupted for 75,000 years before unexpectedly erupting again in 1992. The Fourpeaked Volcano is located in the highly scenic and volcano-rich Katmai National Park and Preserve, where it is centered 98 miles southwest of the city of Homer. Partially surrounded by snow and glacier-covered peaks, the small summit of Fourpeaked is northeast of the Kaguya caldera and southwest of the Douglas volcano. This volcano gets its name from one of the glaciers which covers its edifice and is known as the Fourpeaked Glacier. Although covered by a thick ice sheet, the overall volcano measures about 9 miles wide and stands about 3,300 feet taller than the surrounding older glacially carved mountains. This still impressive height suggests that Fourpeaked has been erupting for at least 25,000 years, but this figure assumes that it had the same eruptive rate as the nearby Mount Augustine. Based on the extent of glacial erosion on its edifice, it is likely far older. Although little is known about this volcano, two potential lobes of andesite lava can be spotted on its flanks, which traveled within a 4.25-mile radius of its summit. It can be assumed, based on what little evidence we do have, that Fourpeaked produced moderately explosive eruptions an order of magnitude less explosive than nearby Mount Redoubt. Fourpeaked's edifice represents a typical stratovolcano with overlapping layers of andesite lava and ash. However, there are hints of some more explosive prior eruptions due to the detection of dacite lavas. Although Fourpeaked was not known to have erupted in the last 12,800 years until 2006, this does not necessarily mean that it truly did not erupt during this time span. When a 3,300-foot-long fissure opened on the northwest summit area of this volcano, the heat from a series of phreatic explosions carved out a chain of explosion craters. This heat subsequently melted a large volume of snow and ice, triggering a large glacial flood known as a yokula. This flood carried with it boulders of material up to 30 feet wide, leaving behind a brown to gray coating where it flowed. Luckily, this flood harmed no one, as people do not live within 30 miles of the Fourpeaked volcano. Instead, it flowed down the Douglas River into the Cook Inlet. After the 10-hour eruption ended, the flood ceased. In total, this unexpected eruption was assigned a volcanic explosivity index of a 2. Scientists later noted similar-looking deposits to those generated by the 2006 eruption in other sections of the glacier, suggesting that several previous glacial outburst floods have occurred. This suggests that other recent volcanic eruptions may have occurred in the last 15,000 years, although not all glacial floods are caused by volcanic eruptions. In Iceland, for example, they can also be caused by unusually warm weather or increased fumarole-related activity at a volcano. In hindsight, the eruption during 2006 was not completely unexpected, as satellites detected an uplift signal originating from both Fourpeaked and Douglas between 2005 and 2010, where a maximum uplift of 6 centimeters was detected. Fourpeaked is unlikely to erupt again for some time, but we could be greeted by another surprise eruption in the immediate future, as many nearby seismometers failed, leaving this volcano largely unmonitored by 2020. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank JJ Nella for supporting this channel.